What is up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while. Been busy with the holidays and working a lot, and I hope everyone's doing fine and good and happy and successful, and happy new year. Anyways, usually about this time of year, January, I usually go somewhere hot like Mexico or Hawaii or somewhere to get out of the rain and the cold in Oregon, but this time we decided to go to Whitefish, Montana. So here I am. We are staying at the lodge at Whitefish Lake. Let's go take a little tour of it. What's up, guys? Quick little video of downtown Whitefish. January 30th, 2022. Pretty cool little town. Really kind of cute, artsy, and some really good restaurants. And I'm going in for some breakfast right now at this Buffalo Cafe. So, hope you guys like my channel. Give it a thumbs up. Give it a like, subscribe, share. Help me out a little bit. Thanks, everyone.
guys, I guess first things first, my name's Jesse. I'm gonna be your guide out here today. Who all has ridden before? Who has not? Some riders, some knows. That's you. Perfect. I love it. Give you a quick rundown on how these things operate and how we're gonna run the trails out there. So very simple operation. I used to tell everyone they're dummy proof, but then someone always proved me wrong, so I don't know anymore. Right on top, you get this red button. That's a kill switch. You pull that up, it will let your motor run. You smack it down like that, shuts the motor off, kills it. So in order to start the sled, you pull that up. They'll all have a key switch on them. A lot of these have dead batteries just from sitting out in the cold out here. The cold kills them really quickly, so they'll have a full start too. So you pull your red button up, you try your key. Golden. If the key's not doing anything, it's just cranking and nothing's happening. Nothing to it. If anyone needs help pulling on your board, I'm more than happy to come start for you too. Not a big deal. Throttle on your right-hand side here. So these are centrifugal clutch driven. So what that means for you is there's no gears, there's no shifting, no park drive, none of that at all. They're always in gear, always ready to go. So as soon as you start giving a little bit of gas, they'll rev up, they'll kick in and start taking off. On your left-hand side, you have a brake. It's just like a bicycle brake. Works your back track on here. Also, just like on a bicycle, if you cram that brake too hard, it can lock your track up, make you slide side to side like a bike would. You don't want to hit it very hard, just light pumps if you need to use it. Most of the time, you won't even have to use your brake anyway. As soon as you let off the throttle, it starts slowing the sled down, and we'll all be spaced out on the trail anytime we're going fast. So. As long as everyone's keeping an eye on the guy in front of them, staying spaced out, you never even have to use that brake. Any questions on any of that? How start and run? So steering, obviously your handlebars are connected to your skis. Turn your handlebars, turn your skis. But you have to put a little bit of lean and balance into a snowmobile to make it operate properly. So if you're going around a left-hand turn, you'll turn to the left, lean to the left with it. Going around a right-hand turn, same thing, lean to the right with it. Same thing for like an uneven hill. If you're riding along the side of a hill, it's a little bit uneven. You want to lean uphill to kind of balance that sled out. It sounds more difficult than it really is. It's pretty simple. You get out there for a little bit, you'll have to figure it out in no time. We're just going to run in a single file line. Of course, I'll be up front to show everyone the trails we're going on and where we're headed to. As long as we keep about 100 feet or so between us, if we start going fast, you know, keep about 100 feet between us. When we're going slower, we can bunch back up and get closer. I'll stop several times for everybody out there to make sure your noses aren't froze off yet and let you get some pictures and stuff. Probably use some hand signals while I'm out there. Of course, I can't talk to you like this, so real simple ones. This means we're coming to a stop. This means we're slowing down. And this means kill it. You just knock that button down. So anytime I'm doing either of these here, everyone in line does that sign behind me. It tells the guy all the way back that we're stopping. Any questions? Alright guys, you guys ready to do this?
Yeah. What's up, everyone? What is up? Beautiful day. Whitefish, Montana. Out here doing some snow machining or snowmobiling, however you want to say it. Beautiful day out. Having fun?
Yes.
Sure. Nice condos,
yeah.
Huh?
I think the last time we snowed, skied.
Oh, look at that place.
Oh my god. Hi. You guys want to
my next house.
I know. Why don't you come visit us at our house in Whitefish? It's nothing. It's just a little something. See, that's how I want to look, right there.
Yeah, right? Not in this lifetime. Whitefish, Montana.
Woohoo!
Snowmobiling yesterday, skiing today. Today. Jeez, look at that house.
Oh.
Perhaps.
Oh my
Says home again. Says down this way.
Okay, if you can see it, I can't see Russ.
Down this way.
Get in and go.
Just making sure. What?
You carved the whole mountain. Use your pole. Kind of use your hip. You know? Kind of take them a pole down.
I'm trying to slow my speed down.